Hi there. So we have now configured MIDI in and MIDI out for instruments and controllers for different digital audio workstations. Next, we will dive into Reason and see how Reason is configured for MIDI. I will also introduce a practice how to synchronize multiple external synthesizers with Reason and some ideas for you for your studio to do so as well if needed. So let's get going with Reason. Okay, let's look into Reason how the MIDI in and MIDI out is configured for instruments and control surfaces. So first you need to go to Reason and Preferences, and from there you need to select the MIDI tab if you haven't already. So you select the MIDI and over there you have two areas. You have one for remote keyboards and control surfaces, and then you have the MIDI inputs. And then here you need to enable those that you want to be able to listen. So the MIDI message is coming in that you want to listen, and the ports that you want to listen and use, you need to enable them. For example, if I would like to use Juno X as my external keyboard to Reason and get the MIDI messages in from Juno, I would need to enable this like so. But I don't, so I'll just leave it out as is, right this way. And I have Lumi keys enabled and Machina and a few other MIDI controllers that I use to control, like Monogram module and so on. So this is what you need to do in order to enable the MIDI in. Then if you want to add a remote keyboard or control surface, you can do it automatically. It will scan through all your devices and see what is matching and what is not. But you can also go and add manually, and I will do that. So you could select, you know, a manufacturer. Rolly is not yet added over here, so I just leave it to other. Then if this is a MIDI keyboard and no controls as it is, I'm just selecting the MIDI keyboard and no controls. So there are several options that you could basically then select. Also multi-channel control surface. This could be your mixer, like a mixer device that you have, like UF8 or something else that you connect with your Reason. But in this case, I'm just basically adding a keyboard as an example, and then I give it a name, Rolly Lumi, and then I select the right input, which is Lumi keys block, and then I say OK, and now I have my keyboard configured. So this is pretty much what when it comes to MIDI in, and then next we will look how to do MIDI out with the MIDI device. To use an external instrument, I can go and add device, and in this case I could go and into Reason Studios and I do MIDI out device. This MIDI out device is pretty easy to set up, and I can easily go and say that okay, let's go to OBX8 and channel 10. And then of course I would need to add an audio track to get the synthesizer audio in. Now I need to remember in Reason that what's the channel for my OBX8, as you can't name these in Reason. So I need to kind of remember that as you remember from the previous session. And then if I start to now play on top of MIDI channel, I'll hear the sound from my synth. And that's all fine. I can also, of course, send, as you see, I get MIDI in, I get MIDI out. Okay, so in Reason, in order to synchronize external synthesizers with Reason, you actually need to do a bit of a trick in a sense, because Reason is only capable of sending the synchronization clock to a one single port, and it's configured here in the sync tab, and from here you can actually select into which port you will send the MIDI clock output. Some people are using an external multi-clock like ERM or so. Myself, I have a Mio XL that I can configure to route the MIDI from a certain MIDI port into all the MIDI ports out. And that's what I have done. So in Mio XL, you have basically 8 MIDI ports in and 12 MIDI ports out. So I need to go into the routing, and basically this is a software that I use to configure the Mio XL MIDI device. So I need to go to MIDI routing settings, and I have actually taken this channel like AST6 MIDI clock sync. And what I have done here is that when I'm selecting this from my DAW, it will send everything that comes into this channel to all the MIDI out ports. So in this sense, I'm using this for the clock to be sent out to all the ports right here, which are all together those 12 ports that goes out. And that's basically it from my point of view. But there are, like, you can use MIDI splitters, or you can use multi-clock or different type of devices to split the MIDI messages to your external synthesizers. For myself, this is actually the way to go. And then now on here, when I go and select, I know that this HST7 is the port that is sending the MIDI then to every synthesizers that I have connected to my MIDI device. So when clicking here on the send clock, you can see that my devices get active, and the MIDI device will start to broadcast the MIDI clock to all the you know, the synthesizers, as well as drum machines in my system. And this is how I can get the clock synchronized with all the external devices through that Mio XL. But as said, there are other ways to do that also, using an external multi-clock or a splitter or whatever you may figure out. But anyway, that's the kind of main thing in Reason, that you need to be able to split the MIDI information from Reason from one port to multiple ports in order to synchronize your external synthesizers. Other than that, everything is great and fine. So that was Reason, and how Reason is configured for MIDI in and MIDI out for controllers and external instruments, as well as how to synchronize the clock for multiple external synthesizers, for example. Next, we will continue the saga with workflow tactics, and focus will be on presets and libraries. So how to configure your library, how to utilize the browser, how to save your presets so that you can get fast access to your virtual instruments and plugins in order to, you know, speed up your workflow. Remember to subscribe for the channel for the more great content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.